Yes, sir, we promised you a great
gorgeous
main
event. Gorgeous,
George. Pretty classy, the maker of
champions. Andre, the challenge.
WrestleMania.
Everyone has a place.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is electric.
You are fired. The champ is here.
The Barrett Barrage has laid waste to WWE's Apex Predator.
I've got inside the Viper's head like nobody ever before. Randy, there's only one voice in your head right now. Mine.
But Tonta Viper, be prepared for a strike.
I have him exactly where I want him.
Tonight, after pushing Randy Orton over the edge, the brazen Wade Barrett must now face his target one-on-one. But this time, it's falls, count, anywhere.
Wade Barrett thinks that he's in my head, when really, my opponents should never underestimate me.
It's the final SmackDown of 2011, and only one may see 2012 in one piece.
And based on those vicious actions by the WWE's Apex Predator last week, Wade Barrett seeks retribution. It's Wade Barrett versus Randy Orton. Falls count anywhere. A huge main event tonight on Friday Night SmackDown.
Yo, guys, I asked for this time. I just had to say a little bit of something before we get this thing kicked off. I want to thank the WWE as well as the fans, because 2011 has been an awesome year for Booker T. You know, it started at the Rumble. I came in as an unexpected entry, and I'm gonna tell you, you fans made that a night that I will never forget for the rest of my life. Yeah. And then I was willing to take a step back and go into the next stage of my career in the commentary booth, and it's been all good other than dealing with Michael Cole every week.
Take a step back? That's what he considers
and
this?
And then Cody Rhodes. Let's not forget Cody Rhodes. He did everything he could to drag me back into that ring. And I'm gonna tell you, I didn't jump on Cody Rhodes behind his back. Monday night, every one of you seen exactly what happened. I went in there and I beat Cody Rhodes 1, 2, 3 in the middle of that ring. The guys, like I said, you're the ones that's responsible for that. And like I said, I want to thank each and every one of you. But tonight, is the final SmackDown of 2011. So sit back and enjoy. And like I always say, guys, if you want to join in with me on this one, the kid you did.
The Intercontinental Champion, Cody Rhodes. Who's the sucker now? Let me
go. Now I know you people here in Indianapolis don't read the newspaper, don't keep up with current events unless it has to do with taking a left on a racetrack, are your once proud, now pathetic Indianapolis Colts. But we're recapping the year, so I felt it vital to recap my year. I overcame a career-threatening injury. I went on to defeat Rey Mysterio at WrestleMania. And then I brought honor and prestige back to the Intercontinental Championship. And then, and before I say this, no offense, I took a washed-up announcer, and I got him to reach back and regain some of his former glory. I also...
Whoa. Wait a minute, Cody. Let me interrupt you for just 1 second. You can come out here talking about whatever. You can call me anything you want to. But let me tell you something. Monday night, I beat you in the middle of this ring. Now, if you had any respect for this business, you wouldn't be out here running your mouth. You wouldn't be bumping your gums right now. What you would be doing is saying, congratulations, Booker T. You did a hell of a job. That's what you should be doing, son.
You're absolutely right. I know this is the last show of the year, and I don't want to come off as some sort of bitter jerk. I'm better than that. So you want it? You got it. Congratulations, Booker. Of course, now this is all over.
What'd you say? It's all over. What you talking about, man?
This little fairy tale you've been living, has nobody told you? You're a nostalgia act, Booker. And now you're in no man's land. If you continue to compete, your deteriorating skills will become exposed. If you go back to announcing your legacy as an in-ring competitor, well, it's slowly gonna become you having a reputation as a semi-literate buffoon of an announcer. Booker, I don't know how else to tell you. You're a joke. So, with that in mind, do me a favor. Do them a favor. Do yourself a favor, Booker. Go home.
Ladies and gentlemen, that there is Cody Rhodes' older brother, Dustin. Both, of course, the sons of the Hall of Famer, Dusty Rhodes. Now, Dustin made a name for himself as his alter ego, the bizarre and controversial Goldust.
But this isn't the Goldust we've come to know over the years. No theatrics, no face paint. Goldust seems to be, well, Dustin seems to be all business here tonight.
Cody, I'm real sorry. You're my brother, and I love you very much. But, Cody, I mean, you're going about this the wrong way, okay? I see exactly what you're trying to do. This is Booker. You don't have any respect. Now, let me tell you a little story here. When I was down and out, and you know I was, and I was battling every single demon that I had, do you know who inspired me? Booker T did. Look at me when I'm talking to you, Cody, right now. When I thought it was all over for me, he took me under his wing, okay? And I had the best time that I've had in my career, me and Booker, when we tag team. Now, I get the whole, I gotta make a name for myself, but not at Booker's expense. And you know that's wrong, Cody.
This is priceless. I mean, just when I thought there couldn't be a bigger joke than Booker T, here comes my own brother trying to prove me wrong. I don't care about inspiration. These people aren't worth inspiring. And did you say, I know better? I'll tell you what I know. I know I restored the Rhodes family name after you threw up all over it. And how inspirational is Booker T, considering as soon as you were done teaming with him, you fell right back into said demons and then into total obscurity.
Oh, whoa, wait one damn minute, man. Let me tell you something. Gold is more man than you will ever be. You understand me? And it ain't about Goldie. It ain't about me. It's about you, Cody. Let me tell you something. You got one win. I got one win. Let's say we do it one more time. But this time, we make it for the Intercontinental Championship, and we can do it right now, dog. We can do it right now. We can do it right now.
I would be careful what you wish for, Booker. I'll agree to one more match next week. And after I beat you, you can follow my own brother into complete irrelevancy.
I think not, Cody. Because let me tell you something. Next week, dog, I'm going to celebrate. All these people in this arena, they go celebrate. Gold and I, we go celebrate. Because next week, I will become the new Intercontinental Champion. And you all can say it with me. Now, kid, you dig that sucker?
I want you all to mark your calendar. Next week from Little Rock, Arkansas, that'll be the city where Booker T is going to fade off and become irrelevant once again. That will be the night that Cody Rhodes put Booker T in his place on SmackDown.
Or will the first SmackDown of 2012 see Booker T, a five-time WCW champion, become the Intercontinental Champion?
We're going to find out next week on Friday Night SmackDown.
Oh,
oh man. Look at this.
And Cody Rhodes with the cheap shot to his brother, Dustin.
Now, you can call it a cheap shot. The bottom line is this. Dustin should have stayed out of it. It's none of his business. Dustin should have handled this situation in private. He shouldn't have come out here and aired the Rhodes family laundry.
And Dustin was not expecting this right here from Cody Rhodes. The cheap shot and then this right there. The swift kick right to the face. Cody Rhodes to his own brother Dustin here. Well, still to come tonight here on Friday Night SmackDown, one of our main events features the World Heavyweight Champion Daniel Bryan teaming with the man Bryan cashed in his Money in the Bank contract against The Big Show as they'll battle the self-professed world's smartest man and the world's strongest man, Mark Henry. It's tonight.
We are global entertainers.
Professionally trained athletes.
WWE superstars.
But we are not invincible.
When we step into that ring,
we take real risks
and endure unimaginable pain.
Broken bones.
Torn muscles.
Dislocations.
Separations.
Be smart.
Be safe.
Don't try this at home.
Comes to a close, WWE.com counts down the top 25 matches of the year. Find out which bout was the best in 2011. I bet me and Lawler in WrestleMania is among them. All right, nice to have a conversation with you guys out here, talking to myself as usual.
This next match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Madison, Mississippi, weighing in at 225 pounds, Ted DiBiase.
Second half of 2011 has been great for Ted DiBiase. He's really connected with the WWE Universe, and that's kind of drawn an outburst from some of DiBiase's fellow superstars.
Well, DiBiase looking to settle the score here tonight, upset over what happened a few weeks ago. It all began in this matchup between DiBiase and Heath Slater. DiBiase was rolling. In fact, he would use his patented finishing maneuver named Dream Streets to knock off Heath Slater. But it was what happened after the matchup that really ticked DiBiase off. Jinder Mahal has not been pleased after a number of run-ins with DiBiase over the past number of months. So what does Mahal do? He attacks DiBiase from behind, and he makes DiBiase suffer. He would do this with a devastating camel clutch, a throwback to the past that Mahal has perfected here on SmackDown.
And from Punjab, India, weighing in at 222 pounds, Jinder Mahal.
Well, the aggressive and mysterious Jinder Mahal has made it clear he doesn't understand or like American cultures, and earlier had this to say about New Year's resolutions.
हर एक साल कहने हो, make more money, lose weight. But year after year, you Americans make false New Year's resolutions. But you are all stuck in mediocrity, just like Ted DiBiase, whose year will end in defeat.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is great. We're rejoined now in ringside by the man Cody Rhodes termed a, quote, semi-literate buffoon of an announcer.
What does that mean anyway?
Well, you're semi-literate. Doesn't it shock me that you don't know what it means? But the bottom line is this, Booker. I think your New Year's resolution should be to stay with us out here at ringside and stay out of the ring. Enough is enough. You got lucky on Monday.
You caught
lightning one last time, and now you're going to do it again next week?
That is my New Year's resolution, to sit right over here and do my thing. You know, I'm having a great time. Cody Rhodes, he asked for this. This is not something I really want to do, but I'm going to tell you something. I'm going to step up to the plate, dog. Just like Ted DiBiase.
Ted DiBiase quickly getting the best of Jinder Mahal. Mahal has really taken exception to the fact that DiBiase, well, he hangs out with members of the WWE Universe. DiBiase has his posse party every week before SmackDown.
Yeah, I bet that was great in Indianapolis.
Cover here by Jinder Mahal, hooks the outside leg, and DiBiase quickly
DiBiase
kicks
and
out.
A bunch of Hoosiers. Ooh, that would have been fun.
Like you say, Josh, Ted DiBiase has been rolling this second half of 2011. But let me tell you, Jinder Mahal is looking to make a big play going into 2012, I'm telling you.
Jinder Mahal very aggressive here on Ted DiBiase. The Hall says 2011 will not end well for DiBiase. Cover here by Jinder Mahal as we roll through Indianapolis, Indiana tonight.
You know, I was thinking, I got a whole list, Josh, of things you should do to be your New Year's resolution.
Like what?
Well, first off, be a better announcer. That would be one. I could go through the whole show on this stuff. Second off, get a suit that fits. Third off, hit the weight room every once in a while. Want to keep going?
Who's talking about the weight room? Let's forget him. Look at Jinder Mahal right now. Jinder's got this boy dead stretched out.
Jinder Mahal feels that much of us, the WWE Universe, are stuck in mediocrity. And that DiBiase's year will end in defeat here on the final SmackDown of 2011.
That's the definition of you. Oh, this is great. I'm having so much fun.
DiBiase quickly.
Last SmackDown of 2011. Great action like this in the ring.
Yeah, you need to pay more attention to the action in the ring.
Definitely do.
Yeah, so should you, Booker. Next week, I can't wait until Cody Rhodes takes you apart.
Oh, man, I'm not worried about
Cody. Tremendous impact. Jinder Mahal down here, and DiBiase so close to a victory there.
Cody Rhodes is a young kid that needs a whooping, and that's exactly what I'm going to give him come next week. And Cody Rhodes, I can't stand this kid. Exactly what he's doing right. I can't stand him. I'm about to lose my cool right now, so let's get off Cody Rhodes.
You know, Rhodes and DiBiase used to be buddies.
Hold on a second. DiBiase tweaked his knee there. Jinder Mahal capitalized. We don't really see Ted DiBiase go from the top rope very often, and it might have cost DiBiase a match here.
That's why they call it high risk, Josh.
Oh, watch this. Watch this.
The same maneuver that Jinder Mahal put on DiBiase 2 weeks ago. This camel clutch.
What do you say? What do you
devastating say? Maneuver. Throw back to the past.
A submission maneuver, DiBiase had to tap out.
I'm going to tell you right there, look at Mahal, he's got the knuckles right in the eyes, and that had to be some excruciating pain.
Wow. Jinder Mahal.
So Jinder Mahal ends 2011 on a high note. A victory here over Ted DiBiase. Booker, do you expect big things from Jinder in 2012?
Let me tell you something. I like Jinder Mahal. Going into 2012, this kid is going to be a force to be reckoned with.
Yeah, I'm having a special New Year's Eve party. Yeah, tomorrow night. Oh, I've got it all. I've got noisemakers, I've got horns, I've got party hats, I've got everything I need. Hey, I got to go, dog. Oksana?
Daddy, I'm so happy.
And why is that?
Oh, I can't wait for New Year's Eve party, especially when I have special New Year's kiss for my favorite little teddy bear.
Kiss for me?
Yes, for you.
Oh, yeah. I can't wait either. Oh, yeah.
Teddy Long.
Oksana, if you'll excuse me for a minute. Okay. I'm Drew McIntyre.
How are you, old friend?
I'm good.
Rumor has it you waited to see me. Here I am.
Well, I signed you back to SmackDown.
Thank you for that.
Now, let me remind you, I know that we've had our issues in the past, but I'm all for forgiving. Now, when I brought you back, I didn't realize how much money you were making. And when you were here on SmackDown, you were one of the fastest rising stars in the WWE. But when you went to Raw, your career just kind of spun into a tailspin. And I'm not interested in paying someone as much as you make when you can't get the job done. Now, don't get me wrong. You're as talented as they come. But I can't have someone here on SmackDown that doesn't have that passion that you once had. So tonight, when you face Ezekiel Jackson, if you don't get the victory, I'm afraid I'm going to have to start thinking about letting you go, player.
There is nobody in this company with more passion than me. And Teddy, you don't have to worry about me at all. I'm still the same guy that can make a man get down on his knees and beg me for mercy. Just like it did to you.
Wait. Listen, see, you, with that thick Scottish accent, I can't understand nothing you're saying now. Just slow your roll, dog.
I'm sorry, Teddy. If you have any reservations about my ability to still get the job done, make sure you watch what I do to my opponent tonight. Did you feel me, player?
Your favorite fox, Alicia.
The leggy and athletic Alicia Fox.
I am more talented.
before than you.
Never short on attitude.
And Fox always had that attitude. It's sexy at the same time.
The way Alicia swings her hips, it shows you that she is a gifted athlete.
Feistiness about herself. That's what I like about Fox.
The most fierce Divas champion in history.
Introducing first the team of Caitlin and Alicia Fox.
Alicia Fox.
Check out Alicia Fox. I gotta say it. Don't do it like that, baby. My goodness.
What got into you tonight? Well, ladies and gentlemen, Alicia Fox has really been on a mini roll as of late. It started 2 weeks ago against Natalya. Natalya having her way with the Foxy one. And Alicia would fight back. Now watch Fox take control of this matchup right here. Rolling up Natalya. And then, well, Alicia would get a little bit of a souvenir, guys. And that souvenir would be a lock of Natalya's blonde hair.
That's actually called an inside cradle, Cole.
Okay.
Not a roll-up.
Whatever. What's it matter? We're storytellers out here. What are you worried about your inside cradle next week when you get beat by Cody?
The team of Tamina and Natalya.
What do I look like, Jim Ross, Gordon Solison out here?
Natalya seems to be all business here tonight. Her greatest feat is making the other divas cry. She'll look for some retribution here tonight, teaming with the daughter of Superfly, Jimmy Snuka, Tamina.
Let me tell you, I think Alicia Fox just looked over and winked at me, man. Did you see that?
No, yeah. But I did see earlier today you giving Alicia Fox a lot of pointers.
Yeah.
There you go, Booker being a biased announcer again.
Let's get this action rolling right. I can't wait to see Tamina. I'm gonna tell you, she's got a mean streak.
Well, there's a reason she has a mean streak.
Quick crossbody by Caitlin.
It's in the genes.
As I mentioned, the daughter of Superfly, Jimmy Snuka, Tamina. Another cover here by Caitlin. Grew up, well, basically idolizing her father. She grew up in Hawaii. She would cliff dive from high feet into the Pacific Ocean. Just imagine.
Hey, come on,
high altitudes.
Hey, you're not the
high altitudes.
Yes.
Hey, wow, check that out. That's what I'm talking about. As far as Tamina, she's got a mean streak. Doesn't mind, you know, doing something a little underhanded. I like that.
Hey, Tamina, you got to get out. You got
to
get out.
And in comes Natalya.
Two, three, get out, Tamina. You got to get out.
Natalya looking very pinky tonight.
Cover here by Natalya and Caitlin. Natalya told me that she will spend New Year's Eve with her cats.
What?
I thought you were going to say the rest of the hearts.
No.
Can you imagine that party?
Get
out
there.
Oh, my God.
It's ridiculous.
Tell us about the cats. I can't wait to hear it.
That was almost a potential submission maneuver there by Natalya. Just looking to embarrass Caitlin here. Looking to get a little, as I mentioned, retribution from what happened last week to Alicia Fox.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you, that was a lot of strength right there by Natalya. Oh, big move, but check it out.
And here
she comes.
Wow.
That's my girl.
Oh, look at that. Oh. Booker T. Jr.
You got to love it.
The scissors kick and the victory for Alicia.
Can you dig that?
That was beautiful. Did you see the height on it?
Caitlin and Alicia.
Alicia Fox continues to trend in a positive direction. Another victory here, I'm going to tell you.
You talking about taking control.
Tamina taking frustrations to a whole new level.
And look at this.
Oh, boom!
Shades of her father. The Superfly splash from Tamina.
Let me tell you something. That's the warrior princess right there.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, many people claim Wade Barrett is in the head of Randy Orton, that he has the psychological advantage. And here is one of the reasons why. At Survivor Series, a major statement was made. It was Team Barrett versus Team Orton. And watch the leader, the natural born leader, Wade Barrett delivering Wasteland and knocking off Randy Orton at Survivor Series on the grand stage of Madison Square Garden.
And still to come tonight, our main event. This one may end up on the streets of Indianapolis, and it'll all be legal. It's Falls Count Anywhere as the bitter rivalry between the Viper Randy Orton and Wade Barrett continues tonight on SmackDown.
B-Star Alliance is to support the message of anti-bullying across the world.
Bullying is such a big thing now. Over 70% of kids today, they're bullied, and it's something that needs to be stopped.
Don't be a bully. Be a star.
Show tolerance and respect.
Be a star is all about courage.
It's about kids coming together and being supportive.
It's not cool to bully other kids and say mean things and hit them.
It needs to stop, and we all have to try and put an end to it.
This is a way to empower people.
We want to make sure that people have a support system.
You're not alone. You can get through it.
It's a bad epidemic, and we're going to put a stop to it.
Don't be a bully.
Be a star.
Show tolerance and respect.
Now, the Raw Rebound.
Tonga with one arm tied behind his back. Well, the match would indeed take place. There you see the Big Show having his right arm tied behind his back. Otunga would take advantage. But Big Show proved that he could manhandle Otunga with just one arm until the world's strongest man would appear, trying to take advantage of a tied up Big Show.
Yeah, and for the opportunist. was the world's strongest man, Mark Henry, but that drew out the new world heavyweight champion, Daniel Bryan, catching the attention of Mark Henry.
Yeah, the distraction by Daniel Bryan would allow Big Show to retaliate, and David Otunga would pay the price.
I ran down there and I distracted Mark. I rescued the Big Show from Mark Henry. I mean, it could have been disastrous, you know? Like, it was... Oh, hey, Show, I was just telling AJ about how I saved you from Mark this past Monday on Raw.
Thanks, champ. AJ, can I talk to the champ a minute, please?
Yeah, of course.
Thanks.
I'll see you later tonight.
Oh, okay, cool.
Daniel, giants really don't need to be rescued or saved. You know what I mean? Just not a good thing. Just down low.
Look, that's not how I saw it. But tonight we're going to be partners. And so I say, you and me, we just teamed together. Man, we were so good last week.
Hey, sounds good. I'm down.
Hey, I've been looking everywhere for you guys. Now, I'm sorry to be the bearer of bad news, but I've just received word from high above we're not going to have our tag team match tonight. But it seems that David Otunga wants a return match with you tonight, Big Show.
Return with me?
Oh, yeah.
The lawyer's pretty brave. Okay, good.
Yeah, but the difference is Mark Henry will be in Otunga's corner. Holla.
Why doesn't that surprise me?
Maybe Giants need savings after all. Good luck.
We are global entertainers.
Professionally trained athletes.
WWE superstars.
But we are not invincible.
When we step into that ring,
we take real risks
and endure unimaginable pain.
Broken bones.
Torn muscles.
Dislocations. Separations.
Be smart.
Be safe.
Don't try this at home.
You know, Booker, what's interesting about that, you mentioned earlier tonight that you were this past year's Royal Rumble. Anybody can win the Rumble.
You know, that's the good thing about the Rumble. I mean, there's so many guys out there. Just being in the right place at the right time, that's what it's all about.
This match is set for one fall. Introducing first from Cape Town, South Africa, weighing in at 213 pounds, Justin Gabriel.
And this is the final SmackDown of 2011. The high-flying daredevil, the Cape Town werewolf book, Justin Gabriel.
Justin Gabriel, I'm going to tell you, this matchup right here, Justin Gabriel better be on top of his game because this one is going to be awesome.
Oh, I love this.
And from Juarez, Mexico, weighing in at 205 pounds, Unico.
How much that ride cost right there, Josh? Well, we're talking about...
Yeah, the lowrider bicycle, very expensive. These are custom-made lowrider bikes. We'll talk about those throughout the matchup. But earlier tonight, Unico, well, he had some words for the WWE Universe. Unfortunately, I don't speak Spanish, but here's what Unico had to say.
This is my homie Camacho from back in the barrio. As we were the Reyes back in the hood,
we plan on taking over the WWE in 2012. Simón este. Orale, vato.
Interesting. So we've been introduced to Camacho, a buddy of Unico's, being brought up in the barrio. Of course, Juarez, Mexico, just across the Rio Grande River from El Paso, Texas, as this matchup gets underway.
And Cole, you were telling me earlier that you have a lot of knowledge when it comes to these custom-made low-ride bicycles.
Yeah,
what kind of knowledge do you have about a low-rider bike?
Are you going to let me explain or not? The lowrider bicycle was developed in the 1960s. It was a way for the Chicano culture, the Mexican immigrants to
check out Unico here!
Be able to have flashy style when they couldn't afford the lowrider automobiles. And they basically started out with these Schwinn bikes, and then they would pimp them out, so to speak.
Unico quickly into the cover of Justin Gabriel
with
powers out.
These long wheelbases and stylings, banana seats, sissy bars, the ape hanger handlebars, as you see on this this bike out here, overspoked wheels as well. In fact, many people date this back to Eddie Munster developing the fad for the lowrider bicycle and his Dragula and Monster coach bikes.
How much time did you stay up last night Googling that information is what I want to know.
Booker, I live in McAllen, Texas. I know a lot about the culture.
And now Justin Gabriel trying to get something going here against Unico. You see the presence of Unico's buddy Camacho on the outside as Gabriel takes flight.
I'm going to tell you one thing about Justin Gabriel and Hunico. These guys can match each other move for move in the middle of that ring, so you got to mind you. Keep your eye on the prize, dog.
Tremendous counter by Justin Gabriel, who told me that in 2012 he wants to crack Booker T's Fave 5.
He's getting close, I'm going to tell you that right now.
Gabriel in position, but Hunico quickly counters.
Keep dreaming, Gabriel. Hunico's going to be in the top of the Fave 5 if this keeps up.
Let me tell you something, Hunico, this guy, he's totally known for his high-flying, acrobatic moves. Check
and
this
Hunico
out. Beautiful.
And that's gotta be Justin it. Gabriel looks the outside leg. And
wow. Hunico, how impressive.
Did not tell you.
Here is your winner, Hunico.
I tell you, Hunico and Camacho, what a team. They're going to be the real deal, I guarantee you guys.
I don't know a whole lot about Camacho, but Hunico, this kid has got a hell of a future here on SmackDown. Not just SmackDown, but the WWE. The hell's going on?
Hey, oh, wow.
Look at that.
Goodness.
Oh, man, a sign of things to come.
Come on, guys, let's go. Get out of here. Come on, guys, out of here. Let's go. Come on, out. Let's go.
Guys, we may have just looked into the crystal ball ahead to the year 2012 on Friday Night SmackDown. It could be domination time for these two, Hunico and Camacho.
I'll tell you something, Camacho is in shape and he's ready to go, dog.
Check out that ride. Well, I love the banana seat.
Let's check this out right here. Camacho just snatching Justin Gabriel Book out of midair.
Definitely did just draft him. Somewhat of a drop, somewhat of a neck breaker at the same time. These guys got it going on.
So a great end to 2011 for Hunico and Camacho here on Friday Night SmackDown. And earlier, well, it was supposed to be a tag team matchup, but Mark Henry cannot compete, but David Otunga asked for a return match from Monday Night Raw against The Big Show. If you're wondering why, well, it's because Mark Henry will be in the corner of David Otunga next.
Mark Henry, the world's strongest man. If you saw me in the street, I promise you, you would not look at me cross because you know that I would break your face wide open. When you're dealing with the world's strongest man, somebody's gonna get their ass kicked.
Barrett Barrage has laid waste to WWE's Apex Predator.
I've got inside the Viper's head like nobody ever before. Randy, there's only one voice in your head right now. Mine.
But Tonta Viper, be prepared for a strike.
I have him exactly where I want him.
Tonight. After pushing Randy Orton over the edge, the brazen Wade Barrett must now face his target one-on-one. But this time, it's falls, count, anywhere.
Wade Barrett thinks that he's in my head, when really, my opponents should never underestimate me.
It's the final SmackDown of 2011, and only one may see 2012 in one piece.
Well, it's the beach. Oh, it's a big bad show now.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring. Standing at 7 feet tall, weighing in at 441 pounds, the Big Show!
And the man is truly a giant, but in 2011, the Big Show, after a 9-year world championship drought, became the world champion for just 45 seconds. Booker, I want to get your opinion on that in just a few minutes, but let's take you back to last week on SmackDown and just the sheer power alone of the giant, the Big Show.
And again, guys, this is absolutely ridiculous. This This happened last week on SmackDown. David Otunga showed up to tell the world Mark Henry was not physically able to compete. And what does Big Show do? He attacks the attorney. He attacks the lawyer with a right hand and knocks Otunga out. Absolutely ridiculous. Otunga was going to sue Big Show for everything he was worth. But the fact that Otunga got that matchup on Monday night we showed you earlier on, well, the lawsuit's been thrown out the window.
I hear you, baby.
Why do all these people kowtow to you?
That's my boy, man. The Big Show.
And from Hollywood, Florida, weighing in at 229 pounds, David Otunga.
David Otunga, the Harvard Law School graduate, the legal counsel to Raw's interim general manager, Mr. John Laurinaitis, wanted this matchup tonight against the Big Show in Brazil. Supposed to be accompanied by the world's strongest man, Mark Henry.
What was he thinking? I'm going to tell you, after getting his jaw jacked from the Big Show, and I'm going to tell you, the Big Show moved with purpose tonight. He's got that right hand taped tonight. David Otunga.
I mean, Booker, enough already. Stop putting this guy down. Give him some credit for having some guts, for coming out here tonight facing Big Show like a man, one-on-one.
That's what I was just going to say. I'm giving him credit. He's been
jumping. Oh, now you're jumping the bandwagon to the other side again.
David Otunga is a hell of a guy just coming out here tonight. Oh, here we go.
The mammoth extreme heavy for David Otunga here tonight. Former world heavyweight champion who just ran roughshod over WWE in 2011, Mark Henry.
Go ahead. I just want to explain to everybody the reason that Mark, a Big Show, is so angry with Mark Henry and Mark Henry vice versa. Remember back at TLC, Big Show defeated Mark Henry to take the world title from Mark Henry. Then Mark Henry knocked out Big Show with a DDT to a steel chair, allowing Daniel Bryan to cash in Money in the Bank. So these two got a huge beef with one another.
Huge beef is, I'm gonna tell you something, having Mark Henry in his corner over there, that reminds me of when I used to get into a fight and having my big brother watching my back. Always gave me a whole lot of confidence.
You know what? You may want to bring your big brother back for the matchup with Cody next week.
See that right hand for the Big Show?
This was scheduled to be a tag team matchup. The Big Show is supposed to team with new world champion Daniel Bryan to take on Otunga and Mark Henry. Mark Henry cannot compete here tonight, so a one-on-one matchup.
And Booker, what kind of a competitor are you? What you just said speaks volumes, that you would only get in a fight with your big brother backing you up. I mean, I thought you were some tough guy.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, if my brother's watching my back, it might scare the guy just a little bit, give me a little bit of an advantage. That's really what it's all about when you go into a fight, Cole, something that you have never been in before.
Maybe you should bring your brother to your matchup next week to help you out with
what,
Cody.
Man,
might, you need, I got to remind you that I'm undefeated
at
WrestleMania.
Tell you what, maybe I will.
I ain't got to do nothing. You got to do it.
Let's go, son. Let's get him in now. Come on now. Let's
get him in. Do what's over.
Let's go. One. Two.
Where's your pride?
Three. Let's get him in now.
Mark Henry. Mark Henry, like that.
I mean, he's barking orders at this boy. Get back in there and take a beat. That's what he just said, dog.
David Otunga having second thoughts here about going one-on-one with the Big Show.
I would, too. Look at Otunga go. Look at him standing up to the Big Show here.
That's what I'm talking about. Oh, my goodness.
Nearly 500 pounds running through David Otunga.
You said that right, Josh. He just mowed that boy down with ease.
I don't even know how Otunga's back to his feet after that.
Wait a minute. This for Mark Henry right here. That's a message right there, Doc. Didn't I tell you, Big Show tonight is moving with purpose, man.
Well, Mark Henry's hurt. That's the reason he couldn't be involved in this matchup
tonight.
Well,
why the hell is he out here?
Well, because he wants to see what's going on. He wants to scout his competition.
Hey, come on now.
Yeah, look at Otunga.
David Otunga from behind with a chop block. Big Show down.
Otunga better stay on the Big Show. He better stay on him. He better keep his feet moving. Stay on your bicycle, Otunga.
Well, look at Otunga here.
Huge chance for David Otunga.
Upset. The Big Show powers out.
Not tonight, baby. This is the final episode of SmackDown 2011. It ain't going to happen, dog.
Come on,
did you see Big Show toss Otunga out of the ring when he kicked out of that cutter? Uh-oh.
Daniel Bryan!
What the hell?
What is that? Black? The world heavyweight champion, Daniel Bryan.
What is he doing out here?
This is Dean Bryan coming to the rescue right here, dog. He said he was going to do it.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Otunga.
Daniel Bryan has taken care of Mark Henry. So now perhaps the Big Show can take care of David Otunga.
Oh, wait a minute. Big Show's got that right hand ready.
Bam!
Oh, my goodness.
The WMD, the weapon of mass destruction, and the victory for the Giant.
Good night, David Otunga.
What a series of events here tonight. David Otunga thought he had big time backup in the form of Mark Henry. Daniel Bryan comes out, draws the attention of Henry. Big Show wins.
Well, he did have backup, but right now it's way, way back, like in the back in the dressing room somewhere. Big Show pulled it out, dog. Check this out right here.
Out of nowhere, Daniel Bryan from behind with the World Heavyweight Championship off the back of Mark Henry. Let's see if we can see where Daniel Bryan at. Yeah, right there, over the barricade.
But again, let me emphasize, from behind, that was an ambush, an attack, a mugging on Mark Henry.
Of course it was.
He's supposed to be the world champion.
Check this out right here, this big right here. Big Show turned the hip on that one and totally just put that boy to sleep.
That is conduct unbecoming of a man who's supposed to represent this show and this company.
Incredible night thus far on Friday Night SmackDown as we prepare for a Falls Count Anywhere main event match, Cole.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, the Wade Barrett and Randy Orton rivalry continued a few weeks ago at TLC pay-per-view. It was Orton versus Barrett in an incredible tables matchup. And it was just back and forth throughout. Wade Barrett off the Winds of Change side slam would have Randy Orton in control. Barrett going for the victory. But watch Orton from out of nowhere. An explosive RKO through the table. Orton evening things up. Well, at that juncture.
A Falls Count Anywhere match basically equates to anything goes. Can Randy Orton deliver another devastating RKO? Can Wade Barrett be as sadistic as Randy Orton? These two may go all over Indianapolis in this arena here tonight in our main event.
Ezekiel Jackson has been on a tear because of power like that.
This guy's jacked.
That's like a real Superman, size of a truck, bowling balls on his shoulders.
The strength and power of Ezekiel Jackson.
I am the personification of domination.
The unstoppable juggernaut of destruction, Ezekiel Jackson.
There will be no stopping. It's when you go harder than somebody, man. This right here is domination.
This next match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Guyana, South America, weighing in at 280 pounds, Ezekiel Jackson.
Booker, you and I had a conversation with Ezekiel Jackson earlier today. Jackson has some big-time New Year's resolutions planned for his career here in WWE.
Zeke says he wants to get on track here in the WWE. He wants to do something big in 2012. The question is, can he do it? Does he have the skill to get it done? We shall see.
Well, Drew McIntyre, a former Intercontinental Champion, better get on track for 2012. He had a stern warning from SmackDown General Manager Theodore Long. Drew McIntyre has a very lucrative contract and needs to start performing.
And from Ayr, Scotland, weighing in at 254 pounds, Drew McIntyre.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, from the chosen one to the desperate one, Drew McIntyre. Earlier tonight, SmackDown General Manager Teddy Long told Drew McIntyre that despite signing a new contract with SmackDown, Drew hasn't exactly lived up to his billing as the chosen one. And if he doesn't shape up, Teddy Long made it perfectly clear he's going to begin to think about perhaps cutting Drew from the SmackDown roster.
Drew McIntyre claims that he's not lacking passion, but Booker, do you believe that Drew McIntyre is a pressure player?
I think he's a pressure player, but I'm going to tell you, Drew McIntyre lost focus when he stepped into that broad. I mean, the competition may have been a little bit too stiff for him. Let's see exactly what he can do here on SmackDown. Can he make a move?
Chelsea tonight.
Ezekiel Jackson quickly into the cover. Jackson 6'4", 280, very powerful.
You know, I don't often agree with General Manager Long, but I do in this situation. There's so much young talent waiting in the wings here on Friday Night SmackDown to make a name for themselves, wanting one of these precious spots each and every Friday night. So a guy like Drew McIntyre, who's making a ton of money, needs to come out here tonight. He needs to show that he's worth the money and that he's worth being on television every Friday night. Bottom line, it's a business.
Definitely, it will shake up things around here. When you start firing guys when they're making a whole lot of money, it gives those guys back in the locker room something to work for. And that's really what this business was built on, dog.
And we talked, guys, about him being the chosen one. That was a name given to him by the head of the WWE, Mr. McMahon.
Jackson quickly into the cover here.
I mean, you look at the guy. I mean, he's got the total package. I mean, he's got a hell of a look. He's got a hell of a body. I mean, if he do the right thing, he will have a hell of a future in this business.
But look, how much pressure is put on you when you arrive on the scene and automatically a legend in this business, the man who created the industry.
Jackson hooks the outside leg of Drew McIntyre.
Mr. McMahon dubs you his chosen one. I mean, that's an extraordinary amount of pressure.
Well, let me tell you something. That may be more pressure than one can handle. I'm telling you, a young man can handle Drew McIntyre.
What a cheap shot there by Drew McIntyre. And now McIntyre looking to capitalize here, hooks the leg once again of Jackson.
The thing is, Drew's he's a young guy. He's still got a whole lot of time, but in this business, they're not going to wait on you. You got to step up to the plate and do your job.
Booker, by the way, you haven't talked about Ezekiel Jackson at all in this matchup.
You know, Zeke's going to have to show me something, like I say. He says he wants to make a move in 2012. He wants to do something big. He has a perfect opportunity tonight. Beat Drew McIntyre in the middle of this ring, and you got a ticket in the game, kid.
And now, nice.
Throw there by Drew McIntyre. Ezekiel Jackson just barely escapes. As we look at this cheap shot here by Drew McIntyre, unbeknownst to the official.
Well, I'm gonna tell you, if the referee didn't see it, it wasn't a cheap shot. That's just a part of this business right there, dog.
Jackson trying to turn things around here.
Every show you have a different take on everything.
Ezekiel Jackson, he had a decent 2011. He broke away from a group, decided he wanted to be an individual, was the Intercontinental Champion
for a minute.
Do you believe Zeke has all the tools over there?
I do believe Zeke has two. I mean, the experience back there. I do think Zeke needs a lot more guidance than what he's had thus far. Maybe he needs to talk to Booker T, 6-time world champion. Maybe that could help.
Anyway, I think that the thing with Zeke, a lot of people have also said about Zeke that he has the tools, but he's got to get more aggressive. He's got to get more vicious in the ring. He's got to have that mean streak.
That's something I talk about all the time. I mean, having that mean streak.
Hey, wait, Drew, don't get disqualified here.
Oh, wait a minute. Did you see the strength of Big Zeke right there?
Yeah, but look at Jackson was looking for the torture rack, the signature submission maneuver.
Wait a minute. Oh. Wow.
Drew has to win this, guys.
Cover him, Drew.
Jackson down, stacked up on his
shoulders. Hey, what are you doing, huh? Why do you do your foot on the road? I'm not going to count that. That's a two. What are you doing? Why would you have your foot on the rope, huh?
Well, Drew's disqualified. It doesn't help his cause as well.
Is Drew McIntyre becoming a desperate superstar?
Oh, look at this
Jackson.
Here. Look at this here. And come on. Jackson at the tights.
There will be no stop.
Ezekiel Jackson.
Did you see that?
Ezekiel Jackson out of the tights, guys.
And Zeke did something I've never seen him do before, but I'm going to tell you, that's what it's all about. It's about going out there and getting a victory. Big Zeke did that. 2012 may be his year.
The only thing going through the mind right now of Drew McIntyre are the words of SmackDown General Manager Theodore Long. If McIntyre doesn't start winning, Theodore Long's going to be thinking about letting McIntyre go, firing Drew McIntyre.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you, go ahead, go.
No, I was going to say, you can see the emotion on the face of Drew McIntyre. He realizes that this was his chance here tonight. Now he's trying to explain to the referee that Ezekiel Jackson had the tights, and Zeke did.
I'm going to tell you right here, big Drew McIntyre did something special right there, but he got caught, and the referee did his job. He was desperate
right
there.
Watch this, though, guys.
Right there, he's begging.
Watch Ezekiel Jackson. There's no doubt here, Jackson's got the tights.
Wow.
Okay. Illegal maneuver.
Only illegal if the ref sees it, John. That's what this business is all about, getting the victory.
You got to wonder what General Manager Theodore Long will think about the effort. Put forward by Drew tonight.
And there's the great white, the Celtic Warrior. We understand we're going to hear from the only Irish-born champion in WWE history. It happens next on SmackDown.
I come from a long line of Celtic warriors.
I'm all about having a laugh, a good time, because I'm generally a nice guy. Reputation for being a hothead. Let's just say, I'm spirited.
Too many lies, oh, too many lies.
The Grey White, the Celtic warrior Sheamus.
Don't let that smile fool you. When he's provoked, that Irish temper comes out.
Sheamus, a hothead, a mean streak.
Two-time WWE champion, a king of the ring.
I don't think I've seen anyone make as big an impact here in the WWE as quickly as Sheamus.
There will be only one man standing at the top. Me, the Celtic Warrior.
Obviously biased. He's had a problem with me since I got here. It was all the referee. That can't count. Teddy, do not count that. It was blatantly the ref. Tell me I'm wrong and I'll call you a liar.
You know what?
What?
I can't stand losers, player. Especially losers that makes excuses. You feel me, player?
What's the crock, Indianapolis? You know, everybody is talking about the end of 2011, but I don't want to talk about the past. I want to talk about the future and what will be, and that is the Royal Rumble. Think about it. 29 fellas flying over the top rope, all types of shenanigans going on, and the winner getting the ultimate prize, a championship match at WrestleMania. Now I'm gonna go on record and say, I don't care what number I draw. I don't care who I eliminate. The fact is, I am going to win the 2012 Royal Rumble!
Oh, wait a minute. Now we go have some fun.
Oh, God.
Hello, Hornswoggle.
Booker T's best buddy, Hornswoggle.
He's better than you can talk. I mean, you can say whatever you want to say now.
I think they should take him to Times Square and drop him with the ball on his head.
Look at this. It's the little fella who eliminated me at the Christmas Battle Royal. Don't tell me. You're going to enter the Royal Rumble, aren't you? You think because Daniel Bryan beat the Big Show that miracles happen every day, don't you? What's the matter with you? I thought you could talk. Tell me, who do you think is going to win the Royal Rumble?
Hornswoggle, 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 Hornswoggle.
Okay. You know what? I actually admire your confidence in yourself. But as my great-great-granduncle, Finbar McSweeney, once said in the Black Summer 1847, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, you're begging for a kick up the arse.
See this guy.
The one-man Southern rock band, Heath Slater.
Bushwhacker Luke, the Brooklyn Brawler, even you, Hornswoggle. There's always that one guy that says he's gonna go off and win the Royal Rumble, but no one takes them seriously. But I'm not that type of guy. And Sheamus, you're not the number one redhead on SmackDown. I am, not me. Would you look at it? You know, I liked you better when you didn't speak. But then again, I didn't even like you then. And the only reason you won that Christmas Battle Royal is because Sheamus, he didn't want to squash a leprechaun. But I'm the one-man Southern rock band Heath Slater, and I don't have that problem.
You know, fella, I've absolutely nothing against Southern rock. I mean, I hear it's quite good and, you know, fair play to you for spreading the word. But I bet you see yourself as a Journey type of guy, don't you? Huh, Journey? You know Journey, right? That had that huge, massive international song, remember? Yeah. Remember when they did, Don't Stop Believing. Yeah, you know that song, don't you, huh? Well, unfortunately for you, I see you more as an R. Kelly type of guy. You know R. Kelly? Yeah, R. Kelly, you know, I believe I can fly.
Whoa! Whoa!
I'm speechless.
Yeah, just like that, Sheamus sending Heath Slater flying over the top rope.
Ah.
I believe I can fly.
Perhaps a message being delivered by the Celtic Warrior guys. Remember what Sheamus said when he came out here. Sheamus wants to win the Royal Rumble match, punch his ticket to compete for a championship at WrestleMania.
I think it goes a little bit something like, I believe I can fly.
All right, we got the point last week with the silly rendition of Rudolph. Nonetheless, can we talk about what's going to happen later on tonight?
Oh, my bad.
Well, Sheamus continues to bull rush over SmackDown as we get closer and closer to our main event. It's Falls Count Anywhere Goal between Randy Orton and Wade Barrett.
Well, nonetheless, tonight after TLC, when Randy Orton put Wade Barrett through a table, Barrett turned the tables on Randy Orton. Barrett fueled the fire. It would be Barrett's right to send Orton crashing through a table. The rivalry reaches its climax tonight.
And still to come, the latest chapter in the saga between Randy Orton and Wade Barrett, only this time it's Falls Count Anywhere. On the last SmackDown of 2011, will it be Randy Orton or Wade Barrett victorious?
We are global entertainers.
Professionally trained athletes.
WWE superstars.
But we are not invincible.
When we step into that ring,
we take real risks
and endure unimaginable pain.
Broken bones.
Torn muscles.
Dislocations. Separations.
Be smart.
Be safe.
Don't try this at home.
We are back on Friday Night SmackDown. During the commercial break, our general manager, Theodore Long, made this match. Sheamus one-on-one with Heath Slater.
Yeah, look at Sheamus go. He got all fired up when Heath Slater interrupted his little repartee with Hornswoggle.
Sheamus quickly into the cover here of Slater.
Not really sure what Heath Slater was thinking, but right now he's in the wrong place at the wrong time. On the wrong side of town in the ring with this boy, Sheamus.
You know, there's a lot to be said, though, for what Sheamus said earlier on. I mean, he is going to be one of the favorites, no doubt, heading into the Royal Rumble matchup the last Sunday in January.
You know, I agree with that, Cole. I mean, Sheamus will be one of the favorites, but like I said, the Royal Rumble, anything can happen. There's no way you can watch your back at all times, and that's what that type of match is really all about, man.
Well, Sheamus claiming that he will be victorious in the Royal Rumble match, punch his ticket to compete in the main event of WrestleMania.
God, it's got to be so frustrating and so emotionally draining when you're in that Royal Rumble match with a chance to go to WrestleMania, and you're tossed over the top rope, and your feet hit the floor, and you're eliminated. Booker, how's that feel?
You know, it is. It's a feeling that really can't be described. Ooh. I mean, you think about it for the rest of the year because that was your one chance to have that championship shot. But I'm going to tell you, the guy that wins it, he's going to go to his hotel room that night. He's going to be so happy because he will have that shot. Oh, my goodness. This is a rad tag. This is called a beatdown right here. And I like it.
Fury. Remember, the winner of the Royal Rumble match gets to choose what champion he will face at WrestleMania.
And that's the good part about winning the Royal Rumble. I mean, it's your choice. I mean, you get to choose which title
Sheamus
you want.
Sheamus off the elbow cover here.
WWE champion, the world champion, whoever it is, you're going to put yourself in good pride fashion if you can win it. That's what it's all about. Check it out.
Uh-oh, look at Slater.
Great move by Slater, but I'm going to tell you, he don't have enough muscle to get this big man down right here.
Yeah, Slater trying to overpower the 272-pound Sheamus.
Too much weight right there.
Nice move by Slater.
I'm going to tell you, one thing about Slater, he's game. I mean, he's not a guy that...
Oh!
He's not a guy that you could just look over in the middle of that
ring. Slater cover here, hooks the head. Have to be considered a huge upset should Heath Slater defeat Sheamus here tonight.
Monumental.
I'm going to tell you, Slater got like a 1.5 right there. Get that cover. Hook that leg right
quickly
there.
Quickly into the cover is Slater again.
I didn't even get a 1 that time. Sheamus is amazing. Every time you try to put him down, he's kicking out before 1, 1.5.
You've got to be impressed with the tenacity here of Heath Slater.
I'm totally impressed. But what that does, it's like hitting the guy in the jaw and he just walked right through it. That's what that's all about. Sheamus is telling Heath Slater, you're not going to keep me down. You're not going to beat me. That's what Sheamus is all about. Listen to the people.
Slater taking it to Sheamus here. Big opportunity.
Slater doing his best to hang around here with the Celtic Warrior.
Slater's showing a mean streak here.
One victory, one huge victory of a guy like Sheamus. That could do something for Slater. I'm going to tell you, Slater's looking to make a move here tonight.
And to Booker's point, a win here would do just that. A win over the Great White Sheamus.
I mean, that's what it's all about. You always want to, you know, pick the meanest dog out there to go out there and jump on. And right now, Slater has picked Sheamus. And Sheamus, hey, they don't get no meaner than Sheamus. Like you said, win tonight could do something huge for Heath Slater, the one-man rock band.
You saw the intensity in the eyes of Sheamus moments ago. And here comes the Celtic Warrior.
Here we go.
Fire in his belly. Here comes Sheamus.
Oh, there he goes. That's what I like about Sheamus. I mean, this guy's just raw bone. He's nasty. He's mean. And it's all about going out there and picking up that paycheck, man.
That's what I love. I love when Sheamus goes up top here. I like to call this the battering ram.
Sheamus sizing up Heath Slater, launching himself into the air.
I tell you, this is a time right now when Heath Slater should really be worried. He needs to think of something, and he needs to think quick, man.
The fire in the eyes of the Great White Sheamus throat kick.
That kid put up a good fight, but he just got put to sleep.
Here is your winner, Sheamus.
So the Celtic Warrior came out here on SmackDown, made the claim that he is going to win the Royal Rumble match, go on to headline WrestleMania, an impromptu match with Heath Slater.
And check out this front kick right there. That's what I'm talking about. Sheamus will put it on you at all costs. That's what I'm talking about. Going into the Royal Rumble, he's ready.
It's all in the eyes of Sheamus.
Another victory over David Otunga. I mean, I think I'm really becoming his good luck charm.
Well, Daniel,
why did you want to see me, right? You called me in here.
Exactly. Tell you, why did you want to see us? God knows I need my little good luck charm to save the day. I mean, at first it was kind of cute, but honestly now you're starting to annoy me.
Annoy you? I'm starting to get annoyed because I have yet to receive a single thank you.
Thank you?
Not one.
You expect me to thank you? Your help wasn't warranted or needed.
I don't see why you can't just give me one.
You know what? That title's going to your head. I'm telling you. It's going to your
head. Wait. Just a minute, players. Now y'all can save your thank yous for after next week, all right?
Why? What's next week?
Well, since Raw is having a gigantic WWE title match next week, CM Punk defending against Dolph Ziggler, then I've decided that I need to compete with them. So Daniel, you will be defending the World Championship against The Big Show. Right here, next week, on SmackDown.
You had a good little run, fella. It's okay.
Well, regardless of what happens, at least I know my reign lasted longer than your 45 seconds.
Wow. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the Orton-Barrett rivalry reached an apex last week on SmackDown. The Orton and Barrett brawl spilling into the locker room and then to the parking lot where Randy Orton would water down Wade Barrett. And Orton would continue the assault. Randy Orton paying back Wade Barrett for what he considered months of sins. And then this, Randy Orton, the apex predator of the WWE. Delivering a devastating RKO, but tonight Barrett seeks revenge.
And that was just a glimpse of what's to come tonight when Randy Orton and Wade Barrett compete in a Falls Count Anywhere match. Will we see another devastating RKO from the Viper? Will Wade Barrett get the retribution he so strongly seeks? We'll find out next.
I am Wade Barrett.
Let me just remind you, I won NXT Season 1.
The winds of change were blowing in the WWE.
Then, I went on to spearhead a revolutionary group of soldiers.
You're either Nexus or you're against us. This is the call.
Now I'm finally on my own with nobody hanging on my coattails.
This is the beginning of a brand new era. The era of Wade Barrett.
Shall arrive to reclaim what is his. Powers that be will be shaken.
Shall arrive. Do you understand?
We are moments away from our Falls Count Anywhere main event match between Randy Orton and Wade Barrett here on the final SmackDown of 2011 from Indianapolis, Indiana, but the first Raw of 2012 is shaping up to be incredible.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, Dolph Ziggler earned this opportunity when he knocked off CM Punk in a gauntlet match last Monday night. Will Dolph Ziggler kick off the new year with a bang and win the WWE Championship? We'll find out Monday night live from Memphis.
And that boy, Cody Rhodes, takes on the five-time WCW champ, Booker T, Intercontinental Championship match next week
on SmackDown.
Isn't that you, Booker T?
Yeah, that is me.
And we also found out moments ago from General Manager Theodore Long, the World Championship is up for grabs. The improbable champion, Daniel Bryan, has a huge test in 2012 in the form of the Giant, the Big Show. It happens next week on SmackDown from Little Rock.
Way to personalize the graphics, Booker.
I have voices in my head. They count to me. They understand. They talk to me.
Who's worse, Booker or Shaq?
The following is a Falls Count Anywhere match. Introducing first, from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 235 pounds.
Showed you throughout the night the timeline between Randy Orton and Wade Barrett. It has been a rivalry that has been heating up Friday night SmackDown. Tonight, guys, they take it one step further. Falls Count Anywhere in our main event.
There's a lot of internet geeks chatting about this matchup right now.
Guys, I mean, have, you know, no love lost for each other. And tonight I've been waiting on this matchup all night. Great anticipation. Wade Barrett versus the Viper.
Obsessed with beating Randy Orton in a Falls Count Anywhere match. We'll find out just how fiendish, ruthless, and wicked Wade Barrett can truly be.
I'll tell you guys, I mean, we talk about Randy Orton being the apex predator to the WWE and how he's a loner and he's calculating and he's ruthless. I really think this atmosphere tonight, it favors Wade Barrett because of Wade Barrett's bare-knuckle style. He had to GD and claw his way to the top in order to beat himself. And that type of atmosphere, I really think, lends to what we're going to see here tonight in Falls Count Anywhere.
Tell you something, Cole, I agree with you, but for different reasons. I mean, Wade Barrett right now has momentum. I mean, his confidence is growing daily. And the one thing Wade Barrett has, a lot of these guys here on SmackDown don't have, that it factor, that fight, that fighting intensity. That's what Wade Barrett is all about, and I like that.
So Falls Count Anywhere. This one can go all over the arena, into the streets of Indianapolis. You can only win by pinfall or submission. And Randy Orton quickly bringing it to Wade Barrett.
I mean, did you hear that uppercut right there?
Well, this rivalry has become so personal. For Wade Barrett, he said it's about going through Randy Orton to get a shot at the World Championship. He's attacked Orton at every turn. He's cost Orton matches. He's cost Orton championships. He showed up Orton at the grand stage of the Garden at Survivor Series.
Let me tell you, that tells me a whole lot about Barrett because he's willing to do whatever. I mean, he's willing to go through the toughest talk and to fight to put himself on top. And that's what you got to do in this business right there, Hulk.
And for a guy like Randy Orton, who's on top of his game here on Friday Night SmackDown, his job is to continue to battle against these young upstarts and keep these young guys down from climbing to the top of the ladder and replacing him and taking his spot here.
And that's what that
and
was.
Orton now, cover on the outside on Wade Barrett.
That's what last week was all about. Randy Orton's telling these young guys, look, if you want my spot, you're going to have to take it. That's what that was all about, that beatdown on Wade Barrett, man. I'm going to tell you, right now, Randy Orton could be the most dangerous I've ever seen him, man. Oh, check it out. Oh my goodness. That's exactly what I'm talking about right there. That's a mean
streak. And now Randy Orton, another cover here on Wade Barrett, who escapes it too.
Remember, Falls Count anywhere in the arena.
We're seeing Randy Orton stomp on Wade Barrett's head there on the steel steps. It reminds you of something that Orton said a few weeks ago, that he knows he's responsible for some of the most sick atrocities we've ever seen here in WWE.
Of course, we've seen Randy Orton set guys up and put them out of this business with that boot to the temple, because that move right there, that was just a prelude to what's going to happen.
The Viper coiled. Looking for the RKO, and Barrett with a great counter.
I thought that was it.
Randy Orton clutching his ankle, Wade Barrett grabbing the back of his head. This Falls Count Anywhere match continues on SmackDown.
I'm WWE Superstar Kofi Kingston with an important message for the entire WWE Universe. WWE Superstars are professionally trained performers. The moves we do in the ring take years of practice to perfect and execute safely. I urge the entire WWE Universe to never try to copy what we do in the ring, at home or at school. Stay safe. Don't try this.
The action has gone back into the ring in this Falls Count Anywhere matchup between rivals Wade Barrett and Randy Orton.
And look at Barrett go. He has dominated ever since he countered the RKO before the commercial break. And he is now on the attack of the Viper.
Let me tell you, Randy going for that RKO early tells me he's a little bit worried about what's going to happen in this matchup with Wade Barrett tonight. That's what that tells me, Cole.
Randy Orton, a 9-time world champion. Cole mentioned earlier that Wade Barrett believes in order to become world champion for the first time, Wade Barrett has to go through the Viper Randy Orton. And now Wade Barrett, his first cover of the matchup.
I mean, I look at Wade Barrett. You look at the guy. I mean, he's got a lot of confidence. His walk tells me a whole lot about this man. I mean, he's ready. He's primed. Can he get past the Viper tonight? That's the question right there, man.
Look, that's the second time in this match you said the confidence is growing of Wade Barrett. How much is playing into the mind of Barrett of what happened last week, getting RKO'd on the top of a car from Randy Orton?
You know, it's playing in his mind, but he's coming out here tonight, and he's right back to the game plan. He's right back to that. Oh, my goodness. He's right back to that Barrett barrage, as you just noticed, that big boot right there. So Barrett is primed tonight, man. That's what I see, Josh.
And Wade Barrett wasting no time, going for the cover here on Randy Orton.
I don't think last week's weighing into Wade Barrett at all this week.
Exactly.
I think what's in Wade Barrett's mind is the fact that he owns pinfall victories over Orton. He's pinned Orton before. He's defeated Orton. He beat him at Madison Square Garden, for God's sake. I think that's what Wade Barrett's thinking about here.
And Cole, you've gone on record stating that you believe Wade Barrett's the first superstar to ever really get the psychological edge in the head of Randy Orton.
Look at, there's an example there. I mean, Barrett has dominated this matchup for the past how many minutes? I mean, Barrett is completely, well, until this point, been in control.
Here comes Randy. Randy's got that fight in. But right there, Wade Barrett just stuffed it. He just stuffed the comeback of Randy Orton. He just put that boy down.
But again, it's the psychological edge. It's the mental games.
As Wade Barrett crawls into the cover here of Randy Orton, hooks the outside leg.
Come on. Out. Barrett owns pinfall victories over Orton. He's cost Orton a number of matches over the past number of weeks. He's put Randy Orton to the table. He's done stuff to Orton that nobody has ever done to Randy, and that I think is playing on Orton's mind.
Okay, but you have to look at Randy Orton's resume against Wade Barrett as well. An RKO through a table and tables, ladders, and chairs. An RKO, as I mentioned last week, on top of the car.
Wow, big boot right there by that big man, Wade Barrett. That's the thing right there, man.
Barrett realizes that Orton's in trouble here. Hooks the outside leg, and Randy Orton just slips out.
But I think Booker, being a legend as he is, will agree with this point. I think as an athlete, you have to look at it as glass half full, not half empty. And I think Barrett's got to look back on the things he's done positive against Randy and not the things Orton's done against him.
You know, I agree with Cole. Like I say, Wade Barrett is a guy, like I say, he's stepped up. He's put himself in a great position. A win tonight, it would be great for him. It would be great for his psyche. But I'm going to tell you, Randy Orton is not just going to lay down for that cover, I'm telling you.
Wade Barrett continues to dominate the Apex Predator, Randy Orton, right now.
I mean, if this match was on points right now, Wade Barrett would probably be up three rounds, but
good night, Randy!
Devastating elbow, Wade Barrett with the cover, and Randy Orton stays alive.
Wow. I'm going to tell you, that was a hard kick out there right there by Randy Orton. He still got a lot left in the tank. He did it at 2.5, but instinct helped him out a little bit right there, I think.
Look, to what you said earlier, this is the exact opposite of a match being based on points. This is a false count anywhere fight between Wade Barrett and Randy Orton.
It is, but like I say, just for Wade Barrett's psyche, he knows he's winning the matchup. He knows that Randy Orton is behind, and he's got to do some catch-up right there. Wade Barrett is rolling, dog.
Guys, think about the physical toll that these two men have put on their bodies over the past couple of weeks.
Definitely.
I mean, Barrett RKO'd into the car. Randy Orton put through a table. I mean, in the number of matches they've had against one another. I mean, these guys cannot be 100%. They're beat up out there.
It has been one of the most intense rivalries throughout the latter part of 2011.
Randy went for that clothesline, something he normally sets up. I mean, it's normally a prelude to that RKO. But right there, Wade Barrett, like I said earlier, he just stuffed it.
Confidence growing on behalf of Wade Barrett. Randy Orton slips through. And here comes the Viper.
Got him on the rebound right there with it. Whoa.
This is Randy Orton at his best.
Wow. You can see the little shake Randy gave right before that power slam. Lets me know Randy's ready. He's coiled. He's ready to drop that RKO in at any moment right now.
Looked like Orton was going to go for his patented DDT, and instead, Randy Orton.
What the
look
hell?
Out now! Wade Barrett over the announce table. Wade Barrett sent flying by Orton. The Apex Predator with a look in his eye. Randy Orton is now on the attack. Randy Orton assaulting Barrett, and this is the zone that Orton's got to be in. This is the Apex Predator. And the smile crossing his face as Randy Orton continues to beat and pummel and punish Wade Barrett. Barrett just jumps straight into the referee. And that distraction allows Barrett to get a shot in on Randy. And there they go.
And Randy Orton in hot pursuit of Wade Barrett. Barrett and Orton going back and forth.